Hello, I'm Shruti and we are with Jyoti. Hi Jyoti, how are you?
हेलो, हाउ आर यू? आई गुड,
Very good.
वेरी
अच्छा, तो आज हम क्या सुन रहे हैं? What are we reacting to?
गुड. वी आर वॉचिंग समथिंग. वी आर वॉचिंग अ टेक टॉक एंड
ओह,
या
नाइस.
एंड इट्स बीन
किसकी टेक
हाईली
टॉक?
हाईली रिक्वेस्टेड. कृष्णा कॉल
ओह
के आर
ओह,
डॉलर
वेरी
साइन.
नाइस,
यस,
वेरी
सो
नाइस.
वी वॉच्ड आई स्टैमर व्हेन आई टॉक, है ना, कर्मा का.
हाँ, यस
And
यस.
thank you guys for all the amazing comments under that video because so much good energy was coming our way through those comments. And glad you guys appreciated that we watched that documentary. So everyone requested now get to Krishna's TED talk where he talks about his journey. And it's
Right.
called the talk itself is titled The Art Called Rap. So I think he's going to explain what rap is about. And I have
Probably how
read.
he got into it and stuff.
Yeah, and like we kind of started reactions on the channel with Brother V, and then we got into Krishna's music. So when, as we were reacting to more requests of Krishna's tracks, I did read up quite a few articles just to know his background, sort of. And so I know that he did move to London, then he came back and things like that. So I know some basics about his life, which I think are also covered in this talk. But I don't know all the details, but this is what I was told by my insider, that he talks about the entire journey and how, he got into hip hop and rap and started writing his own verses and things like that because of high school situations and all of that. So anyway, I've not seen this. Let's just get into it and
Yes, absolutely. So calm me down.
see
Let's
what
do
he's all
this.
about. हाँ,
Yes,
चलो,
yes.
ओके. वन टू थ्री लाइक.
So I'm Krishna. I had a song called I'm Ready with Raftaar. Basically, I have been rapping for about 14 years. And I was recently in a movie called Gully Boy, which everyone seems to have seen. But the sad part is that people now see me and say, oh, you were in Gully Boy, and they don't know that I've been rapping for 14 years. That's what Bollywood does. So basically, I'm a rapper. I've been rapping for 14 years from Delhi. I'm going to tell you my story and the topic beyond the light bulb, light beyond the light bulb. I'm going to explain how not giving up has paid sort of dividends. But before that, students here requested me to explain to people what rap music is. I know there's a common notion that, rap is very easy and like everyone can rap because it's just rhyming a couple of words, right? So I wrote something
Who
quickly
thinks that?
for
Who
this purpose.
thinks that?
It doesn't have too much meaning, so don't look for it. But just to exhibit how sort of how we rap and how we put rhymes together. So this is something that I wrote. So I'm gonna rap this out for you. ये है हिप हॉप और रैप से है वफादारी, पर इससे पहले कि करूं मैं देना सलाह जारी, बोलना चाहूं मेरा कलम ही धर्म है, कई लोग जलन से गर्म है देख के मेरी कलाकारी, कला भारी हमारी पर उनको ना समझ आएगी, सच्चाई कड़वी दवाई तो नेक्स्ट केमिस्ट भाई की, गॉट द रेस्ट वैक्स द बेस्ट बेट, प्रस्तुत में नेक्स्ट गेस्ट ऑन टेड एक्स MSIT.
Nice.
So now when you would say okay, this is rap and it rhymes, yes. And you ask people, okay, so what's rhyming here? They'll probably just look at a few of the words in the end, like wafadari, jari, kari, aegi, bhai ki. But I sort of broke it down into all the rhymes that this little piece has, and broke it down into a color scheme. So the colors
Ooh.
are actually matching the words that rhyme. So technically here there are eight rhyme schemes within eight lines.
Oh.
And that is what rap is. So wafadari will actually rhyme with sala jari, which are two words rhyming with one. Then kalam and dharam rhyme there, jalan and garam rhyme there, and rhyme up there. Then kalakari goes back and rhymes with sala jari. Then kala bhari hamari also rhymes with kalakari. And then samaj aegi rhymes with bhai ki, IT. And so this is just to give you a sort of example of how complicated and how technical rap is, So most people might think, oh, rap is very easy, but it's not easy, right? And if they say that, please tell them to make this and show you, right? So this is what rap is, and it's very popular nowadays, and kids are listening to it. But I want to take you back a little bit, maybe 14 years, to a point where I started rapping. And that was, I started rapping when I was 14 years old. And it was more out of necessity because I had, there were circumstances that I moved to London for a few years. And in London at that time, they'd already got a hip hop scene. It was called grime in London, and they started basically. They were already rhyming, and so I was a kid from India that's moved to London, and I happened to go to a school that was pretty rough. So it was not like a nice polished school. So I had to find ways to fit into the school, and I didn't want to be this geeky Indian stereotypical Indian kid who would get picked on because you know all Indian study and you know what the notion is. So I kind of I always liked hip hop music, listening to it. So I thought, why not start writing a little bit and see. What that got me was that got me like almost immediate acceptance at that point, and all the cool kids in the school would be like, "Oh, Krishna is cool. Krishna raps." Right?
I read this.
Became exactly like a novelty this. Because an Indian kid was rapping. So it went from there to then me continuing. Then I came back to India. When I came back to India, there was no hip hop scene. People would laugh if you said, I rap. And they were like, what's rap, right? So from there, not being demotivated because I was still in school, I just thought of did it on my own. I got to college. And in college, I met a couple of friends that also had the same interest. And that kind of led me to think that maybe, I can do something with them. At least there are a few people who can understand what I'm doing because for art, like, you have to have an audience. I mean, I'm not here to make art only for myself, right? So, like, three, four people was good enough for me at that time. And I started rapping, and we started recording songs. And I started getting a little bit of buzz in Delhi. People used to have, like, Bluetooth phones then, and they used to share songs and stuff.
Oh, God.
But I'm from a Kashmiri Pandit family, and education is very important. So I had to go and do my postgraduate. I'm from Delhi University, and I had to go and do a postgraduate. So I went to St. Xavier's College in Bombay. And when I went there, I was sad because everything that I felt I had built up as a fan base, I had lost already. Because I was in a new city, I had no friends, nobody knew who I was, So it was like, oh, do I have to start all over again? And I actually did start all over.
That's always fun, though.
I went and I decided that I was influenced by American rap. That was the biggest thing. I decided that I will go to a label like they do in America and give them my demo CD and say, hey, I've made songs. Will you sign me, right? And this was maybe 2008, right? Yeah. And I went there, so I somehow got a meeting with an A&R. A&R is Artist and Repertoire, and that's the person that labels who signs people. I went and met that person, and I gave them my CD, and I said, this is my CD and whatever. And I don't know what it was fate or whatever, that CD didn't work in his system at that time. So he said, give it to me, I'll listen to it later, and I'll get back to you. And a week passed, and he wasn't calling me back. So I thought, maybe there's something wrong. I out of desperation, called him once and said, can you just give me any answer? And he said, oh, your songs sound too international.
Means he didn't listen to
and
it.
And at that point, I'm thinking,
maybe he did.
It's a good thing, but he's saying it like it's an insult, right? Mm-hmm. Your songs sound too international. I mean, I'm young, and if my songs sound international, you should sign me, right? But that was his justification to say that I could not be signed. So that was the first time that, I was disheartened, but I had a plan. I thought, this would probably be the end of it where I think, oh, this cannot happen, right? But I thought, how can I make it happen? And I thought that I could probably see how these labels work and then, maybe pitch it in a new way to see, is there something that they're looking for that I don't have and that people don't have? So what I did was I desperately tried to get an internship or anything I could do at a music label.
Very smart.
Just to understand the process of how people get signed and why I didn't get signed, right? I tried and I failed to the point that I had to move back from Bombay to Delhi. I was very sad because I didn't want to leave Bombay at that point.
Don't we all hate change?
But somehow one evening I got this call from someone that I knew, an acquaintance, and they said, you know what, there's this label called Universal Music and they have a vacancy, so do you want to try and try going there and So I called them and they said, yes, we have a vacancy. Could you come tomorrow? And I was in Delhi at that point. I didn't care. I got like a Tatkal ticket. I ran to Bombay. I got into, I went there. They gave me an internship, almost no money. I was like, it's fine. I'll do this. Within 3 months of working there, I had my song out on Universal Music.
That's amazing. Right?
That was only because...
Well done.
I had a plan, right? And when I went in there, I pushed everyone to think that hip hop was big at that moment, and it wasn't, right? But I made them believe that just so that I could get my song.
Smart.
And from that point onwards, in 2010, came the point where I thought that, you know, this rap stuff is a hobby, but it could be more. Because in 2010, if you guys remember, a lot of you would have been young, but there was a Commonwealth Games happening in Delhi. And we were basically the joke of the international media. Everything was going wrong. There were scams. You know, people were sort of making fun of us in international news and stuff. And we and our government here had these like big joyful songs coming out with A.R. Rahman, where they had like balloons and all. And I was like, why are people happy, right? This is like the worst state that we've been in the international media, and we are happy.
What is going on?
So there was this official anthem that A.R. Rahman sir had made at that point. So I made something called the unofficial CWG anthem. And it was a song called Kaisa Mera Desh, right? I made the song, I took a half day off from work, I shot the video for 2,000 rupees, edited it within 2 days, and I put it up. This is what the video looked like, really bad, but I put it up and I slept, right? I uploaded it and I went to sleep. And the next morning, this song was number 2 on YouTube at that time, in 2010, right?
Told you, no? Like, yeah, how did that happen?
There had been no rap song that had gone viral at that point, but this was the first one. And I was almost in every mainline newspaper. Everything sort of happened so suddenly. I was taken aback. I was not prepared for it, right? That is a mistake. I was not prepared for it, right? So what happened next was I didn't have anything else. I was like, okay, I have this nice song that's out, but I don't have anything else. And at that point, I have a job and all of that. So I couldn't produce things fast enough, right? And the next song that I put was months later. But by that time, I had realized being issue-based was always a problem because your song died with the issue, right? So when people forgot about this, forgot about the CWG games, the song also was forgotten about, right? So I learned there that, you know, there has to always be a balance between your message, but also the commercial value of what you're doing, right? From there on, I went on, I worked, and I started taking music more seriously though. And in 2012, I made the decision that I was not going to work anymore and I was going to do music full time, right? It was a hard decision to make, but I had to make it. I got a part-time job and I tried to do music on the side. It failed really badly because I was not able to. I was living in Bombay. Prices were, you know, rent is expensive. Everything is expensive. Doing a part-time job and trying to do music is very tough, right? I failed to the point where I had to again come back to Delhi, right? Because this is where my home is. So my parents were like, you know, you're wasting money and time there. Come back to Delhi. I came back to Delhi, and I was going to go to Singapore because I'd got a job there, and I'd come to Delhi as an interim period.
Oh.
But somehow something happened, and that got delayed, and they said, you know, it's going to happen next month, so you have this 1 month. That basically I had nothing to do, but I was in Delhi, and I had a friend that was working with Universal at that point, and he said, you know what, there's this chance that, you know, there could be a slot for you somewhere, right? And I'm like, okay. And I tell my parents, you know, I'm here for a month. Just let me do music for a month. It's fine. Like, I've been doing it so long, and I don't have anything to do anyway. I made 3 songs that month, and I went to Bombay with those 3 songs, just like I had in 2008, and I handed them the demo, but this time they said yes,
ooh,
right? And in 2013, I got signed to Universal Music for an album.
It was written.
And I released that album 2014, and my song, it was a song called Last Night, and it was number 5 on VH1. And that was, at that point, made me believe that there was potential in what I was doing, right? And from there, I kind of went, I did my stuff, and then came the third sort of breaking point in my career, where it was like, I was at a point where I had a major label album out. I put 2 videos out. The second video, I remember, I made the video myself, and my label told me that we don't have a marketing budget for you anymore. And I was heartbroken because I had put in all my money into that video. And at that point, I was like, okay, you know what? This deal and all this stuff is not working for me. So I'm just not gonna do this. I told the label that I had actually a falling out with the label. And I went back to doing a regular job after all of this.
Are you serious?
Right? And I was deeply disheartened at what had happened and all of that. But I'd also lost faith. I thought, you know, I can't do this anymore. How long am I going to do this? How am I going to justify it? I can't keep telling my parents. I'm getting older. You know, all these thoughts were coming into my head. Until I think it was 2000, and my contract ran out. I was about 2016. My contract had finally run out. I was a free artist again, but I had made no music for 3 years, like absolutely nothing. I met a friend, and a friend told me, oh, you know what? Why don't you do your own music? Why don't you start your own label? And I looked at him, and I'm like, you know, I've got a job now, and, you know, I can't start a label, and it doesn't make sense in India. He's like, it doesn't matter. Give it a shot. And I was like, okay, I'll give it a shot. I sat down and I said, okay, Krishna, you're gonna come back after 3 years. Nobody knows you anymore. The scene is forgotten. Hip hop rappers, there are new rappers everywhere. They don't know you. What are you gonna do? I sat for 1 or 1.5 months and I wrote 1 song. And that 1 song was called Vyanjan. I unfortunately can't play it for you here. Otherwise I would have. And I wrote that song because I knew it was going to have an impact. And that is what I was saying, having a plan. This was my plan. My plan was, how do you come back after so long into the scene and still get noticed?
Do something what no one else
does. I wrote a song
does.
Called Vyanjan. Vyanjan basically is the Hindi alphabet. The entire alphabet, and I rhymed and I rapped the entire alphabet out instead of, you know, how we say, curse, whatever, curse, whatever. I did like an entire rap, right? And that song became viral in 2016. It was shared by a lot of people. It was also shared by Raftaar, who is obviously a big rapper. And it was like a big moment for me. And that kind of led me back onto this path, and it led me to the point where I did that song with Raftaar, and today where I've done a movie, and I'm still doing this, right? Mm-hmm. So my point is, I did not give up at any sort of point, and kept coming back and going, and, you know, having the same plan, but just executing it differently to see how I'll get where I am, right? Yeah. So that is sort of, that is a little bit of my story. I also want to discuss, I mean, everyone wants to know, like, why are people listening to rap now, right? Mm-hmm. I think people are, or why the young people are more attracted to it. I think hip-hop and rap has a very intrinsic quality where it's very accessible, right? You don't need infrastructure, you don't need a lot of instruments, you don't need any of that, right? Because those things, in all honesty, come with a little bit of privilege. If you have privilege, if you have some money, you can attend classes, you can go to, you know, you can learn singing, you can learn instruments and all of that. But for people who are sort of devoid of any of that privilege, hip-hop becomes, or rap becomes your instrument to voice your opinion, right? And that is how sort of hip-hop has grown in the West and is growing in India. You have kids that are coming out of, you know, Mumbai slums, Delhi slums, that are becoming rappers because it is easy for them to vocalize their problems in sort of this art form, right? And it's cool, and it has rhythm, and you get attention. You know, it's all of these things together that makes rap so appealing to the youth. And hip-hop has, I think in India, hip-hop took some time to come here. I mean, hip-hop is the biggest genre in the world right now, right? And it's been very big for 25 years. But in India, the difference was that when hip-hop was coming in, it was English, right? It was coming from America. Mm-hmm. And who understands English in our country? Middle class, upper middle class, you know, people who are rich. That is the audience then, right? But it took hip-hop to be localized for it to actually spread, right? So the approach, the hip-hop grows from bottom to top, and it was coming all these years, it was top to bottom, right? So when this entire change happened and people started sort of localizing it, that's when, like, kids started picking it up and saying, okay, this can be my art form, right? And that's partly the reason why rap is big, and I think rap is going to be potentially the biggest genre in India as well, like it is in other countries, right? And just to just to wrap up quickly, I think we need to now also, like, as an audience, we need to embrace hip-hop as well. I know a lot of older generation people think that it's not music and it's, you know, but the point is that hip-hop and rap is creating opportunities in India for young people to be artists, and I think that is super important. So that's what I'll wrap with, and thank you so much. And no pun intended on the wrap with.
I was just gonna say, pun intended. Interesting.
Right. So.
And there's so much to discuss in this, because.
Come on.
So firstly, the fact that, you know, he mentioned Gully Boy right at the start and said that I've been doing this for so long, but now people know because I was in this film. And Gully Boy itself, I honestly don't remember his scene in Gully Boy.
Even I don't.
I know.
Or maybe we remember the scene, but we don't recall his face because, yeah.
This is just complete honesty. I don't remember the scene, maybe because it wasn't long enough, or, you know, it was like there were I love the film. I enjoyed it. But as someone who loves music, who changed her profession because of her love for music, I love the soundtrack as well and all that. I played it a lot on my show. It didn't inspire me to get into hip hop. Because the I feel the kind of the artists and maybe the lingo, and it was more of a Bombay scene, the Mumbai scene, and that style is probably not something that resonated with me very strongly. I mean,
correct,
absolutely.
So flavor ke liye acha tha, lekin as a genre you were like, nahi.
I was like, ha, it's nice to hear once in a while, but it's not something I'm gonna go and look for and you know try and add to my regular listening wala playlist and this and that. So I don't know, and like now through the channel, since I started the channel this summer, is when I've like I mentioned earlier, I think also once we've covered more Delhi rappers, and I honestly I didn't know there were so many Delhi rappers, and I didn't know the work they were doing, but I am really liking everything I'm hearing. So just as a personal preference, I prefer that style, and I wish I'd known it was around a lot earlier. So having said that, I know the film did a lot of good for the genre itself. Because it just full, I mean, that's the power of Hollywood, whether we want to accept it or not, sadly or happily, whatever you want to say, fortunately, unfortunately, it put the spotlight on the genre, and I'm happy about that. Like, it really got so much more of an audience, the genre of hip-hop in the country. So that aside, I want to now try and watch, I think it's there on Netflix or somewhere, try and see where Krishna is in the scene, you know? I think one of the rap battles, like either the one
assumably so, yeah, on must stage. But it'll just be an assumption na, kyunki yaad hi nahi hai actually. So phir ab jaake one can like actually go and figure ke ek minute kahan pe.
I don't like all the names I've heard so far since the reactions have started. I don't remember any of these names being mentioned in the film, which is why I'm thinking that they basically had a lot more of the Mumbai artists and rappers. Anyway, so that aside, he said something about you know, art needs an audience, and you can't keep making songs for yourself.
Kalakar ko kya chahiye? Talia. It's that same thing that, you know, like art needs an audience. You have an artist needs an audience. Khud ke liye kitna kaam karoge? Khud ke liye kitna banaoge? But till you don't hear that, like, but I'll also love how straight after that he said, तीन लोग भी मिलेंगे चलेगा, like, you know, तीन लोग सुन रहे थे उसके बाद, and then he was more than happy के, like, you know, कोई तो है. That was very cute.
Then he had to keep moving from one city to another and this and that, and the sadness that comes with that. So I moved a lot in life, so I understand that sadness. But then for me, like, I decided early on in life that whenever change is coming, it's inevitable. Yeah. I will just embrace it and be like, okay, time to start an exciting new life, make new friends, and let's see what this chapter holds, that sort of thing. But I can imagine your pain as an artist when you've sort of built a little audience and a little community with your own friends, and then you have to leave it and start from scratch again, like, especially when there's no scene, no, in the country, and you're the only, and you feel like you're struggling, and you're like, koi to suno.
Especially when that's your passion, you know, if you have built something jo intend nahi kiya tha aur theek hai usko chhodna pade for your passion, you don't mind it. But if this is something that's your calling and you know andar se that this is what you want to do, tab jab chhodna pade to zyada pinch karta hai. So but I think this shifting constantly would have also, like, really taught him how to go past and how external factor zyada nahi karta, as long as one can change and one can rise to the occasion every time.
Yeah.
And I think that's adapt. A very important lesson to learn. Yeah.
Your ability to adapt evolves with that at a much higher speed, you know? And like, even though he had to move and the changes were, you know, disrupting and kind of, you know, you tend to feel like you're not in balance and things like that with what's going on. But eventually, when you sit down to write and pick up your pen, you're gonna draw from whatever you've seen through all those changes. So,
dude, and right in the beginning, when he explained the entire, you know, the way the rhyme scheme and how things rhyme, that was so brilliant. Yes. I was like, this is not just like one simple poetry. This is like, it's a confluence of poetic things that is happening. And it's basically poets in rap form, like, you know, rappers are poets. That's what I'm understanding out of it.
So that's like he says at the end, he, you know, the older people think this is not music and all of that. So I wanna say that for the younger kids, I know when I was young, I used to think, what are these ghazals and, you know, kawali, I mean, I'd never said it's not music, but to me, it would be a little boring and, you know, like, long. And, but wo bhi poetry thi, ye bhi poetry hai. You know, so the older people need to also, like, open their minds and understand that this is also coming from within someone who's actually sitting with a pen and paper and writing these words and writing these lines and, you know, expressing their innermost thoughts and feelings. So whatever form it takes in terms of musicality doesn't matter. At the end of the day, it's poetry on paper.
Correct.
So, but sorry, I have many more points. You tell me.
Come on.
What
Come
are...
On. So I loved how natural he was on stage. So the first thing that struck me was we've always heard him rap, right? So for the first time you were here, listen, I was listening to him at least talk, because I was just like, 8 minute, you know? So the speaking voice is so different from the rapping voice.
Yeah.
And the singing voice, right?
So and I was pay attention to the voice so much, right? Especially exactly. You. Yeah.
Uh-huh. So I was just like, you know, the artist ke peeche wala insaan is talking right now.
Yeah.
And abhi wo jaise baat kar raha hai, and the way wo dikha raha hai ki uska brain kaise function karta hai, how he thinks. And you get to know so much more intensity, which is where there behind, it's like an iceberg, you know? Ke like, jo peeche hai, aage jo dikh raha hai, wo sirf ek, wo to char मिनट के गाने में खत्म हो गया, लेकिन उस 4 मिनट के गाने की जो लेयर्स हैं वो कहां से आ रही हैं एक आर्टिस्ट के
इतने साल हैं उसके पीछे. यस
एग्जैक्टली. क्या-क्या लर्निंग्स हैं, दैट्स व्हाट वन गेट्स टू नो.
या द एंटायर पर्सोना वाज सो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट वी हर्ड इन सॉन्ग्स, राइट? बिकॉज़ ही इज सो अग्रेसिव एंड लाइक यू नो
वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग.
बट ही वाज लाइक okay.
It was also many times he was just stopping to see. Like I saw that one guy was clicking his picture, na, the photographer. So for that 1 second, he got distracted also. Like he was just like, you know, okay, smile karo ya, aye wo de raha, aye, acha acha, hum kaha the. So it was, that was cute. Like it was very real. It was very like, haan chal raha, kar rahe hain.
Yeah.
Kuch rehearse nahi hai, sab kar rahe hain bas. Nice. Haan, so come on, what's your next point?
No, so like you just mentioned ki kitne saalon ka usme prep hai aur wo 4 minute mein aapko dikhta hai. So I think I remember in one of his tracks there was a line. Was it No Losses or was it the freestyle? I can't remember, but he said somewhere ki jante hain bahut log lekin asli chehra kisi ne nahi dekha. So there's
matlab hint to bahut time se drop kar raha hai wo ki ha matlab like you know your reality of like, situation
like huh. there's a lot more to me. I want to like, you know how he signed with the label. Firstly, very intelligent decision to get an internship with the label, because if you don't understand the business, very practical, very like you know, okay, so they rejected my track, I want to know why, so let me join them and figure out.
Aisa nahi ki bas dil pe le liya, dukhi ho gaye, oh ho, nahi hua, nahi hua, okay, what are we going to do about it? Okay, kya chahiye kya unko, pehle wo samajhte hain, then let's get it
channel your sadness and your rejection is another art. This thing. So so that was very this thing. But can you imagine the disappointment when they said we don't have a marketing budget for you? Like,
I know so many artists
for me. Yes,
they are till date going through this. I know so many, and these are established artists.
Yes,
these are artists who are established and still.
Yeah.
Matlab, millions of followers are there, and suddenly the you know the label will say, "Lekin marketing budget nahi hamare paas."
Yeah.
So abhi kya karna?
I mean, luckily now there are platforms like YouTube and stuff to promote yourself.
Yeah, you can just
I cannot even imagine. And then imagine you've done all this and you've gone back to a 9-to-5 job. Can you imagine? Like, can you just imagine going back to office, clocking in, clocking out at the end of the day, and doing that for another 2 or 3 years? I don't know how long.
And for those 3 years, it's not like he said he didn't even write one song. So it's not like he took out his creativity, ke, you know, like a day job and a secret nightlife type. Ke jahan pe wo, but no.
Can you imagine that? Because it's the 24-hour cycle that goes in repetition, and every day those thoughts like, I'm not doing what I want to do, I'm not doing what I'm meant to do, I'm not, you know, like imagine, like if you do that for 3 years, what a beating it can take on your heart and soul and all of that. So oh my god. But then yes, I mean, Vyanjan is the song you come back with, right? Because you have to do something so eye-catching, just completely like grab people's attention, and he did that. And I have to now say that, like, I can see the bromance between him and Raftaar. No, it's there. We know about
very
it,
evident.
But the fact that Raftaar shared Vyanjan, and Raftaar was already big at this time. And the thing is, you know, because I've seen this enough in life, and just generally, you know, that artists and anyone is very competitive of anyone who's getting into their work space and into their professional arena.
So naye ho, purane ho, koi bhi ho.
Koi bhi ho, koi nahi promote karta hai, koi nahi share karta hai. And I mean, Raftaar shared it. Like, you know, he must have been like, damn, I like this. What is this? It needs to be shared with the world. Practice. Just out of a genuine desire to promote the art form that he's also a part of, you know. So so hats off to Raftaar. And obviously then they must have hung out and met after that and decided to come together in Kalamkar and all of that, you know, the rest of it. But it's very, very rare. You know, there are mostly you find... like mostly you will just find people feeling insecure and just being like, how can I know this? How can I make sure no one sees this? How can I make sure this guy gets ignored? You know, because he might take over my space in the future and that kind of thing. I see that potential. Like, you know, threat is natural. Everybody feels the threat, but to have that confidence in yourself that, no, I know who I am and, you know, who I, like my strength as an artist. And even if he challenges me, I will only get better because he's going to inspire me to up my game. And that's something that everyone can adopt in life as a personality trait. Like if someone is doing something as good or better than you, don't feel threatened. Just be like, yeah, I love it. You know, kudos. I'm going to up my game. Thank you for inspiring me to do that. So
imagine while doing all this and then we have diss tracks. Jiske under the whole point is only ki aap poke kar rahe ho kisi ko aur aap like bahar nikal rahe ho. You're khadedoing a person outside and doing. So which is nice.
Which is part of hip-hop's culture the culture is to battle and the culture is to challenge each other and that kind of thing. But that doesn't
mean... I'm saying to have the balance between the two and to be able to manage that. That's wonderful.
Usme bromance bhi ghus sakta hai. Space is there, you know.
Yes, as long as
you're basically two secure, confident artists who come together and fist bump and say, bro, I like your stuff, you know.
Correct. Wah, isi baat pe jo, isi baat pe. Ho jaye.
So yes, very lame that was, but okay. we tried.
That's us.
And also like he learned from his mistake back in the day when he released a song and he wasn't ready with anything after that. I mean, today we can see he's just releasing one thing after another. Everything is like
that was ready. जितना स्पेस डालना था पहले लाइफ में डाल चुका हूँ अभी जब बोलोगे ऐसे 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 एवरीथिंग विल बी ड्रॉपिंग लाइक
बॉडी आई एम प्रिपेयर्ड आई हैव डन माय होमवर्क आई नो हाउ द गेम वर्क्स नाउ एंड या सो एनीवे आई थिंक दिस गेव अस सच अ नाइस इनसाइट इनटू हिज जर्नी
and to generally understand the journey of any rapper, like you know how rappers think, how they go about it and what the whole genre entails for them to like what is asked of them. So that also, like, it gave me at least quite an insight about, you know, the whole life and everything.
Like, you said this in your first reaction, I remember, like, you know, how hip-hop is, like, you know, no boundaries. You can just express yourself freely and how, like, you know, it's an inclusive genre. And he said it as well, like, it just, it was the means by which anyone who didn't have the privilege of learning music could express themselves and let it out. So,
Correct. So thank you. Thank you for suggesting this one. And I'm so glad we covered it today. And like, you know, we've so thank you.
Like Karma's story, this is equally inspiring because itna time ho gaya in the game. And now is the time, like the last 3-4 years, I think that hip hop's really taken over in the country. And a lot of people are actually going back and rediscovering his older music now. Na?
So example us.
Example us included, totally. I mean, it's Mango, no one appreciated him while he was alive.
Exactly.
So example de rahe hain because so I mean very much around and very happy about it. But you know, the thing is, even when people like find your stuff much later on, it's all good.
Yeah.
So super. On that note, I think I will shut up.
Aur koi point likha hai to bol lo. Aisi kya baat hai? Aur kya? Any other strong points?
I'm just trying to think. But no, I think on that note, I will stop.
Next time.
Yeah. This was really nice.
We've pretty much covered everything that, you know, we could think of at least. And we look forward to covering his next song now, whichever that'll be. And let's see what
album. Album aa gaya. So... I think that's going to be a big one.
So great. On that note, bye-bye. We shall see you the next time. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.